She'll stare at you until you're done.
Oh, she's drooling all over the place. She's starving.
She has a whole bowl of food, a whole bag of food.
You have a new best friend, at least.
Oh, there you go.
January is the new April, and things are busy again. And as you can see, we had three listings this week sell in one day. So now what you're gonna do is you're gonna build up clientele for the back half of the year, you know? And then when, I'm telling you, it's gonna be, I told you guys this last year that, you know, August to December is gonna be tough, and then especially October to December, you guys saw. Every Tuesday, 8:30 a.m., we have a meeting with all the agents to go over all the new listings we have, what's happening in the market, and what they could do to try to make sure that their sellers and buyers have the right expectations going into the week. My point is that you could tell the your buyers just about how things are moving quicker now, and they're gonna start going under contract quicker rather than longer. Like a lot of these people who are, you know, they'll give you a list of 50 places to see, but the reality is that if they know where they wanna be and they see something they like and it sells, they're gonna learn really quickly that they're gonna have to start moving on stuff. You have to inform your clients that, you know, since January's new April, is that this is gonna be the busiest time of year. April's gonna be slower than now. Go back and look at your time hop of like when we posted the closings, is that March, April, May was actually, April, May were the most closings we had. We had like 60 something each one of those months. Or we close in April, that means we went on contract, you know, January, February. I mean, because a lot of people are trying for these like 60 day close and line up, or 75 day close and line up their leases. So take that in consideration. I send these guys a CMA report before I go on my appointment so they have a chance to kind of look over all the comps. I don't like to sit there and bore people with too many numbers, so I'm kind of more or less going to recap what I think I'm pricing. But the first thing I do is I like to try to take a look around the unit and then kind of give my pitch and then talk about pricing. White plank hardwood floors, quartz counters.
Yeah.
Man, I mean, you put some good money into this.
Yeah.
These are all good Samsungs. Okay, so you got all the undermount lighting. This is marble tile, right?
Yeah.
Okay. You went next level with finishes for the building, you know?
Right.
The biggest downside, and it's the thing about like Chicago, is just the fact that, you know, we're bound by comps instead of price per square foot. If you go outside this building, okay, all day long, this makes sense probably for the price that you want. The appraiser is going to come in here, and banks are legally bound to use what they call comp A. Mm-hmm. So comp A's are going to be ones that are in the building itself. Mm-hmm. So if there's enough turnover in one building, they legally aren't allowed to go outside the building.
Okay.
I think you could probably get away with asking like $299 for it, which means the money you're losing is what you put into it, you know, and it wouldn't be like out of control. I know that he wants this crazy price, and I'm trying to keep it at more of a realistic price, but for sellers, they put so much money into it, so they don't want to take a loss. I would sell, and the only reason I'm telling you this, I think this is too nice of a place to rent. There's too much risk in here. I'm a conservative guy. So that's just my suggestion. You know, of course, talk it over with the family.
Yep.
But to me, I think the max you could go is $300,000. I think that's like your ceiling. Cool. Sure. All right, man. Well, listen, I'll get out of your hair. I appreciate the time today.
Thank you so much. Thanks for coming.
Yeah,
really
no problem. No problem at all.
And I will be in touch.
If I had to say on a scale of 1 to 10, if I got the listing appointment, I'd probably give myself like a 5. I think we could have gotten it, but because of price, I'm not sure if we were going to get that one. You know, the goal is always to meet them, take a look around, see what they have to do, and then give them a pitch, talk about pricing. You know, I know something like this, they wanted probably way, way more than what we said, and probably one of the biggest reasons I don't get listings is that I try to price more realistically and I won't take something that's ghastly overpriced. This would be a little overpriced for the building, but I think the way he's designed it, we can make that happen. But some people take things like really, really overpriced, and honestly, they become a waste of time, and I'd rather have them on the back end. So it's the first big snowstorm in Chicago, so you would think there'd be a lot of cancellations, but it is January, and a lot of people who've been looking since the fall can't cancel because their leases are up. And we are collecting a lot of new business because that's what you do in January. So a lot of people are looking, and normally you would get a lot of people who would cancel on a day like today, but people got to get under contract because their leases are coming up, and a lot of people want to keep their meetings on the books because they're nervous. They want to get something bought by
springtime. So that's why I keep saying is that, you know, January is the new April. Things get crazy in January. So no matter how much snow is on the ground, people are still out here looking.
We're doing nothing but listing properties in the next couple weeks. And we're putting four more listings on the market, like between today and tomorrow. We have 50 something listings right now. January just takes off so quick, and you're almost not ready for it because it goes from 0 to 60 really, really quick. Whatever you have going on, put on your calendar immediately. But if you don't have much on your calendar, like, you gotta be ready to work, because this is the time of year where things are gonna come in. January is probably the hottest time to list your property, and it's also one of the hottest time for buyers, because Chicago's most rent-heavy city in the country, and most people's leases come due end of March, April, May, first part of June. So you come back from holiday, it's Jan, you know, this year was Jan 6, because that's when the first Monday was back, and, you know, people come out and they're super excited to start buying again. And for sellers, what's really good is that there's not that much competition on the market.
So even though this is a hot time of year, there's a lot of stuff that can go wrong too. And, you know, today I thought I nailed this one listing appointment, and the seller just told me they decided to go in a different direction. I had a buyer's meeting set up that was referred over me, and they just emailed me and said that they decided to go with a different agent. And then I just now hung up with a seller who I thought everything was going great with the listing, and they were very upset. I can't really give you an exact reason why, but then they fired us. So that's a listing lost, that is a listing opportunity lost, and a buyer opportunity lost. So although January can start off hot, you know, it's not all rainbows and unicorns out there. You know, bad things are gonna happen, and they're gonna happen to everybody. And you know what? Not even Mickey Mantle bet 1,000. You just gotta keep picking it up and, you know, hope for the best tomorrow.
So this year we started something called The Board Don't Lie, and we got a whiteboard to track everything. And we're tracking how many listings people get, how many sales, and that counts how many you have pending and closed, what's your days off, and then what's your total year to date. And what this is supposed to symbolize is your, you know, progress throughout the year. And the reason we included days off is because I think a lot of people take a lot of small days off that then add up to a lot. And then people wonder where the results are. And it's kind of like dieting. If you cheat here, you cheat there, you cheat there, and then you gain weight and wonder what happened. It's always the small things. It's the small things add up to a lot of things. Make sure to subscribe to our vlog, like it, and leave us a comment. Let us know if you think January is a new April.